Hi everyone. Okay, I decided to do some more videos after all. I will of course be doing Temu hauls because, well, that's what I kind of like to do because it gives me reference of what I purchased on Temu so that I stop buying extra molds, ones I really don't want extras of. Because, yeah, memory fails you after you've gone whole hog on Temu. Okay, so I'm not sure exactly which order this is, but I'll put it up in the description. And, of course, in the description, I will also put the links to this order. Okay, here we go. Not completely, sorry about that noise. Not completely all of crafting, but very close. As you can tell, there's an assortment of everything. I have a pack of 500, or is it 400? This one's the pack of 1,000 coffee stirrers that I'm going to be using in the small pots. It'll be much more effective because they're lightweight, won't tip the cups so easily. Then, of course, you have to be able to mix resin. This is an 8-ounce, 1 cup, that has mils on here as well, and ounces. It is silicone, as you can tell, it's sticking. But I wanted it because it's clear. And all markings are on the outside. So that you're not sitting there trying to scrape on the inside. And as you can tell, it is able to be poured easier. Okay. Turn that upside down because eventually I'll end up with fur in it anyways to have to clean out. Okay. Now for molds. This here is a Christmas deer. And it's quite cute. Sorry about the rattling. My husband's at work, so I'm doing this on my own. I don't know if you can tell to see it that well, but I will be doing this one very soon. I did purchase extra of this mold on purpose because, well, you know, it's going to be Christmas and the crunch is on to get things done. Okay, so I know I realize it's July, but it's, 1/3 of July is left, so it doesn't leave much time, especially when everything has to cure. Okay, bought some more tape for doing UV resin for bezels and the open backs and other things. I did learn that from another crafter. I'll put a link to her as soon as I can. But I did learn from another crafter that UV resin, it ages quickly. It turns yellow very quickly, especially if out in direct sunlight for just even a short amount of time. She was talking about she had been to a craft fair and ended up with most of her UV jewelry having gone yellow, and she does a mix of polymer clay beads and such, and then was putting UV resin on top of that, and the UV resin was yellowing and causing the discoloration in odd places. So yes, I probably will use up my UV resin on things I'll probably just give away. And then I will continue on with epoxy resin. I also just ordered polyurethane resin. So when that comes in, we'll be doing some things with that as well. Excuse me. I have allergies and it's really clogging me up today. Now, this mold here is another Christmas mold. And this is a stocking mold. Let's see if we can get you in there to see. And as you can tell, there is a plug here. I don't know what the purpose for that is for. I think if I remember right, it's for adding lights so that you can turn these into lit ornaments. That's the stocking. This one here is the candy cane. And yes, these are quite deep molds. Let me grab my tape measure and we'll see how deep. This is the candy cane mold. And outside depth is, oh my goodness, just a little bit less than, it's about an eighth less than an inch. So 7/8. And as you can tell, this has got a hole for going through. Just for more detail, I guess, for the light up. I will be cramming for Halloween. I have a ton of Halloween molds already, and I just need to purchase some deep pour resin and have a lot more of the regular resin, because, well, I've got a lot of molds that I want to get done and a lot of projects. Okay, Christmas tree. And as you can tell, the light comes in, or will be coming in from the bottom. Now I'm going to have to purchase the lights that'll fit in there because those weren't available. I really do wish they would sell them as sets and then have plenty of the lights available, because it would be so much better to have it all together. Okay, there it is. Gonna say there was another one in here. Now I'm sure only epoxy resin would be smart to use in this, because the polyurethane is very opaque, very dense, so I don't think you'd see much light, if any. And then this one is, of course, an ornament. Okay. By the way, I've forgotten exactly what I ordered, so I'm getting a little surprised too. These are a set of Phillips head and straight head sewing machine screwdrivers. As you can tell, they're very short because you really have tight spaces to work in with sewing machines. I bought one for my sewing machine, and then I bought one for doing odds and ends things in here. Then, well, I thought these were supposed to come in a box. These are not alcohol inks. These are a set of, it's called Group B, and it's a set of 12. This one has mainly the blues I wanted. There's not much in them. They're about a third of an ounce. And this one, okay, that's peacock blue. So not alcohol inks, they are resin dyes. Rose red. Brown. Almost looks black. Violet. I'll put a test card up with each one of these. And label them, of course. Wow, I really can't read that one. I need to get a magnifying glass. Okay, I'm putting it up there. If you all can read that, more power to you. I don't know if it's coming through very well. I know how to do this. You just take a picture of it and blow it up, right? So I'll grab my phone real quick and take a picture. One-handed really sometimes does not work. Oh, it's called Indigos. And this one here, Sky Blue. I'm keeping it far enough away from the camera so as not to cause blurs and all that. I know it drives me crazy when everything blurs out and you can't see it when it's too close to the camera. Black, of course. I guess that's self-descriptive. Green. So we'll see. Like I said, I'll go ahead and do an ink card and see what colors comes up. Red. Three to go. We have yellow. Almost looks mustardy. Emerald green. And we have pink. All right, that's those. I'm going to put those away, though, because I have a cat that loves shoving everything it can off onto the floor. And then plays with them. Right now, I've got a tag, kind of like this, keychain, that has just up and disappeared. Can't find it. That disappeared this morning. Oh. This is a sewing foot. It is for doing edging seams, binding seams. And basically, this part of the foot leaves that from having to get too much of a bite on the edge. Okay. Oh yes, of course, Halloween. This is another Halloween item. I already purchased the cats. I'll get those videos up, honest, I will. I just have to gather everything together and set it to the side and then have my husband help me out. Because there's a lot that I have not recorded in between my last video that was kind of my last video that I ever wanted to do. I got very disheartened. I had joined Claire's Crafty Corners Christmas in July. Thought I had. Sent her the info. Did everything I was expected to do. But never got listed in the Christmas in July. And yes, it disheartened me to the maximum because unfortunately, my family, they don't watch my videos. They're not interested in what I do. Neither is my husband, really. He will help if I ask, but I can absolutely tell it bothers him. And all I ask for is a little feedback, you know. I'm not looking for approval from anybody. I don't care about that. I just want to be able to grow in my crafting and art. That's all. And a little bit of criticism, as long as it's constructive and not just playing out, hey, you stink, type of thing. You know, point out what you don't like. And maybe even give suggestions on how to do something different. That would be great. Okay. Of course, if you like it, you know, hit that thumbs up, subscribe. Ha ha, LOL. Alright, now I'm going to say it. These are chintzy. They're kind of expensive, but they are chintzy. As you can tell, they're only kind of like a cardboard. This one here got bent on its way here, apparently. But I guess it's Halloween. It'll be a little bit more scary, authentic, right? Ooh, my hand is all bent. Ooh, kind of reminds me of one of my arthritis ones. And these are plastic sticks that get put into the ground. That's all. Different ones. You know, different ways of everything being done. This is almost a reverse of that one, but not quite. Then we have this one. They're like zombie hands, I guess, coming up from graves. And that's what you get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces plus the sticks. And it's meant for giving you the ability to put, I think, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So yes, 2 per hand. Excuse me. And this here, I'm going to be having an indoor greenhouse. So I need a way to set up a watering system for it. And this is 200 and some inches worth of tubing. And it does come with clips to put it up. I will have to measure the distance between each misting area, but as you can see, it's also got a filter, and this hooks up to a 3/4 inch spigot, just like a garden hose. All right, that's the last of this one. I am very grateful for all you watching, most especially to my subscribers. I don't have many at this point. I remember seeing 61 or 62, which is far greater than the 30 I had when I decided to quit doing videos. It's not that I've decided to quit crafting because, well, I'm a crafter. I'm a painter. I'm an artist. and it gives me something to do. I do watch a lot of videos online of others and their work. But I guess it's long enough video, so I'm gonna say, well, I guess it's good afternoon for those around in my area, since it is now after 1 o'clock. And I will get this video uploaded as soon as possible. Also, I will be working on some resin pieces very quickly here, and those will follow soon after. All right, don't get discouraged, everybody. Sometimes, yeah, life throws you that curveball that you wish had never happened. But wake up with a smile on your face, a song in your heart, and plow through. Life can be good if we make it that way. Good luck, and love you all.